I am disappointed. ROCm is AMD's driver layer for GPUs. It offers powerful access to the hardware, including AI, under Linux. I made a video about this in August 2023 because Linux was the only option for ROCm. And Windows? In November 2023, I made a video about ROCm under Windows, expecting AMD to finish the development. And now? What about the missing ROCm components for AI? Hi, I'm Patrick. With this channel, I want to explain technology and AI clearly and correctly. In the first part of this video, I provide an update on the status of AMD's ROCm on Windows. And yes, I've heard you, I'll keep the update very short. If you would like to delve deeper into the matter yourself, watch my first video on this topic. In the second part of this video, I have a fantastic solution to bridge the waiting time for ROCm. Zluda, an open source project that enables unmodified CUDA applications to run on AMD GPUs with nearly native performance. Well, ROCm on Linux is still 10 to 15% faster, but for this speed increase, in most cases, I will not boot from Windows to Linux. So, as you might have noticed, I'm quite excited about Zluda. We'll use it with SD.next, which is a fork of Automatic 11.11. Let's begin with the current status. A lot of AI tools like Stable Diffusion, Automatic 11.11 require PyTorch. ComfyUI relies on it too. But PyTorch with the fast AMD driver ROCm is not available on Windows. On GitHub we find a related issue, which is still open. On the AMD ROCm page, the AI components MiOpen and MiGraphics are not available. For both components, we can see on GitHub, a lot of issues have been closed, but there are still open issues preventing a ROCm release on Windows, including these two components. There are rumors that ROCm 6.1 might include the missing AI components, but I couldn't find an official statement from AMD. Another rumor expects ROCm with all components on Windows within this year, but there is no evidence either. Nevertheless, the probability is very high. As soon as ROCm for Windows, including all components, is released, I'll make a video about it. If you don't want to miss it, press the subscribe button. For the ZLUDA installation, we create and enter an appropriate directory. We create a MiniConda environment, including Python 3.10. If you haven't already installed MiniConda or Git on your machine, check this video. We activate the new Conda environment and download ZLUDA, as some DLLs for Stable Diffusion are missing in the original ZLUDA from Wozen, we use the fork from Icy Tiger and download the zip file. We create a target directory. Okay, another name ZLUDA is not very creative, but it will work. All files included in the zip file have to be copied into the new directory. The zluda.exe file can be deleted, it won't be used and sometimes it's triggering antivirus tools. ZLUDA is a complicated story. The development was initially supported by Intel, then by AMD. Although it works well, development has since stopped, so it's actually only a temporary solution. Nevertheless, will you try ZLUDA? Please leave a comment or a like. Now we install the AMD HIP SDK. It's a compatibility layer allowing applications running a subset of NVIDIA's CUDA API on AMD GPUs. In order to download the SDK, we have to accept the license and the download starts automatically. In the installer, there is no need to change any option. Just click install. It takes a while, so be fast forward. Once the installation of HIP has finished, we install Strawberry Perl, as one of the HIP commands does not work without Perl. Simply download the 64-bit MSI file. accept the license, and enter a suitable directory. Again, we fast forward this installation. For a working Zluda installation, we have to add two folders to the path environment variable. If you want to read the details, see the link in the description below. Nevertheless, it's important to open the next dialog in admin mode, otherwise we cannot edit system variables. We select the path variable and click Edit. Create a new entry and insert the path of Zluda. Additionally, enter the path of your hip bin. Click OK and OK in order to close the dialog. The next step is important if you do not have an AMD RX 6800 or better. In the ROCm system requirements, we find the GPUs which are supported by the HIP SDK. If your GPU does not have a green tick in the HIP SDK column, this section is for you. Otherwise, you can jump to the next chapter. From Breaking Souls Git repository, we download the ROCm libs zip file. Link is in the description. The zip file contains a library directory. Find the original ROCm library directory on your PC. I suggest renaming it by adding something like old. Then you copy the library directory of the zip file at the same place where you find the original library directory. I won't do that. On my PC with an RX 6800, it's not required to replace the library directory. So far for the preparation. Although we could use automatic 1111 web UI, SD.next is a simpler option. SD.next is a fork of automatic 1111 web UI. You will become familiar with it immediately. The installation already takes Zluda into account, and automatic 1111 would require several more steps. We clone the repository, change to the directory, and call the web UI BAT with the Zluda option. That's all. Since the installation takes a very long time, let's fast forward. The web UI can be accessed with same URL as automatic 1111. We select DreamShaper 8 as model, and for the first test we put in a prompt. The first generation takes very long, so we fast forward. Okay, it's finished. On my machine it took around half an hour, but that's only for the first run. The reason is Zluda, which compiles and caches GPU code for the application and accelerates it. As you will see, all additional generations are much faster. So let's try again. .5 seconds, that's very similar to the duration it took on my Ubuntu Linux. Now, what do you think? Is this a sufficient solution for AMD GPUs on Windows, or do you prefer waiting for ROCm?